In this episode, we are getting into the recent space news, including SpaceX's Starship is getting ready for another launch and was recently ignited for about 5 seconds. The Euclid telescope was successfully launched by Falcon 9 and has started its journey into deep space. And finally, after 2 silent months, NASA's Mars helicopter Ingenuity is back online. This means NASA will now resume its airborne exploration of the Red Planet after 63 days of silence. Subscribe to the channel and let's get into it. This is Adventures in Space. So everybody is probably aware that SpaceX is building their Starship for NASA's Artemis program to send astronauts to the moon in the next 3 to 4 years, or to use it as a moonlander to be exact. Before accomplishing this feat, let's rewind a bit. Back in April 2023, SpaceX made headlines with a first-ever test flight of Starship, known as Ship 24. So it works! The behemoth blasted off from the Texas coastline and soared about 25 miles high. But then, unfortunately, the two parts of the rocket meant to separate mid-flight stuck together. Faced with the unexpected, SpaceX decided to play it safe and self-destructed the vehicle. A spectacular sight, but not quite what they had planned. I've made a full step-by-step analysis of what happened that day and what went wrong in another video. Please find the link in the description. However, SpaceX did not see a setback. They saw a learning opportunity. Fast forward a few months and we have got a new and improved Starship, Ship 25, revving to go. It was not just a paint job, though. SpaceX have made over 1,000 tweaks to their design. One of the changes Musk mentioned was hot staging, a technique often used in Russian rockets. Hot staging is when the engines of the next stage start firing even before the engines from the previous stage have finished. This change is expected to increase Starship's capacity to carry stuff into orbit by around 10%. SpaceX has also improved the Raptor engines. These are the heart and soul of Starship, and Musk mentioned that they were quite a mix in the first test. Just recently, Ship 25 flexed its muscle in a static fire test. Here you can see 6 powerful new Raptor engines roaring into life. Their fire illuminating the Texas morning and leaving a halo of smoke and dust in their wake. The trial that took place on 27th of June seemed to go smoothly, which is great news for SpaceX and NASA. But when can we expect to see Ship 25 launched? The word from SpaceX CEO Elon Musk is that it might be as soon as 6 weeks from now. On July 1st, from Cape Canaveral in sunny Florida, the Falcon 9 rocket took off to the skies carrying a very special passenger, the $1.8 billion Euclid Space Telescope. With this successful launch, the European-led mission kickstarted its ambitious journey to a location around 1.5 million kilometers away from us, opposite to our Sun. It has been launched with one question in its mind. What's the universe actually made of? This Euro-initiated project aims to shed light on the universe's elusive constituents, dark matter and dark energy. Here are some facts for you. Around 95% of the universe is made up of stuff we cannot directly detect or truly understand. It is like being in a room and only seeing 5% of the items in it. Pretty mystifying, isn't it? Well, that's exactly what Euclid is looking to change. Over the next 6 years, it will comply a colossal 3D cosmic map showing where all the galaxies are. It aims to understand dark matter, this unseen scaffolding that keeps galaxies from falling apart. It will do this by observing the tiny ways the gravity of this invisible matter bends the light of distant galaxies. Euclid's first month in space will be a period of acclimation, flying to a location called L2 Point and naturally cooling to space temperatures, while its systems are rigorously checked. Over the next 2 to 3 months, it will undergo performance assessments and possible calibration image releases. It will likely be fully operational in 8 months. If you want to know more about Euclid's mission, I've conveniently already covered it in a full video, and yes, you can find a link in the description down below. After a suspenseful silence spanning 2 months, NASA's Ingenuity helicopter is back on the radar, proving that no cosmic distance is too vast for its communication capability. On June 28th, following its momentous 50-second flight on the Martian landscape, Ingenuity managed to relay signals back to its diligent team on Earth via its trusted partner, the Perseverance rover. This marked a pivotal moment in NASA's Martian odyssey. Let's rewind back to February 2021, a remarkable period when the duo Ingenuity and Perseverance embarked on their adventurous expedition on Mars. From that point forward, it has been a tale of continuous exploration and scientific discoveries on the red planet. Despite its modest size, weighing just 4 pounds, Ingenuity has consistently risen above and beyond its initial brief. Having completed its initial 5-flight roster, the little helicopter assumed a more advanced role as an aerial scout for the Perseverance rover. Sometimes communication between the pair gets tricky, like when a Martian hill blocks their view of each other. That is why we had a bit of a quiet spell recently. But now that Perseverance has popped back into sight, NASA is ready to resume the discoveries. You see, such obstacles are a given when exploring the intricate terrains of an alien world. Occasional communication dropouts are expected, but it is all part of the thrill of space exploration. On its 52nd flight, Ingenuity astounded us all by traveling an impressive 1,191 feet in a brief span of 139 seconds. This high-flying escapade was not just for kicks. Ingenuity was simultaneously documenting the Martian topography, providing crucial information for the team back on Earth. As we currently stand, the initial analysis of the acquired data shows a sense of optimism. It suggests that Ingenuity remains in good operational health. Assuming all systems check out, in the ensuing assessments, we may witness this little helicopter soaring the Martian skies yet again in the upcoming weeks. That was all for today's update, and please share your thoughts with me in the comment section down below. Please give this video some love with just a simple like, since it helped the channel out for real. Subscribe to never miss an update on everything space industry related and more. We do 4 essays every week for you in relevant topics, and if you like this video, you have 2 more in front of you right now. As always, this was Georgie with Adventures in Space, and I will see you at the next one.